this movie. They cast Shiro, and he was going to do mostly his rock and pop like he normally does for the series. And they said, Tim just needs to go back. And they said to him, no, we need opera. We need opera. And then he said, I'm going to make everybody cry. And so, set his theme here. Always be with me in mind. Fight with passion, spirit not temper. Always be with me in mind. Don't bear grudges, but don't be downhearted. Always be with me in mind. So when you live to fight another day, I'll always be there with you. And when you feel the world is calling you, I'll always be there for you. Well, certainly we know that Ichigo is that kind of loyalty, but this is Senna too. Yet the issues in Bleach and in other different anime is what makes a person, whether it's Ghost in the Shell or here. If you're a living person, if you're a dead person, if you're a dead person that hasn't yet passed over into the world of souls or into the Sarate, do memories make you a real person? Well, certainly in the Hebrew lexicon, you are alive as long as you're remembered by one person. And so, we have this moment here where each of us sends this little girl's soul into the next world safely before the evil soul-leading hollows get her. And you will hear this one sung. The other aria is never sung in the movie. It's on the soundtrack. But you have this little opening, and this sets up everything. And I remember seeing this at the premiere, and I was like, oh, what is this, blah, blah, blah. And I heard these first three notes, and Shiro Sugiyuki got me. I heard the notes and just started crying. I'm a sucker. And you hear this theme later. You only get this hint of the theme at the very beginning. But then at the end, when it's time for Senna, when she sacrificed herself to save the world, not just this world, all the worlds from Collider. And she basically dies. She goes back. Her Ryatsu, her spiritual pressure, they say in English, goes back into everything. And Ichigo takes her before she dissolves back to the cemetery because she wants to know, was I really alive? Now, of course, spoiler here. She is a collection of many people that made up one person. And Ichigo does the compassionate thing and lies to her. But for him, she's as real as anything. And in the little epilogue after all the credits, you think that maybe Ichigo indeed is right after all, because you think maybe you see her again. And he's not supposed to remember her, but he does. So recollections become the stuff of life and death for each of them. And of course, she annoys the hell out of him, so he must be in love with her. Right? Whether it's Senna, whether it's Rukia. Right? The only one he doesn't know he's in love with is Orihime. But she doesn't annoy the hell out of him. But she's alive and Rukia's dead, so, you know. But see, here's all the parts that make up her. But even we as normal living people with this theme, we have many parts that make us up. Many different memories that are almost totally different people. The metaphor is here for one week. And I don't mean that glibly at all, but here's the moment.